now because I've got pretty much
courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name.
For the Lord
Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations.
Passion, love that's never failing, let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a Savior, the hope of nations.
Thank you. peace. Those who are divided, he has made one. He has broken down God. To all who repent and believe, he has promised reconciliation. So live as people reconciled.
Amen.
Creed.
In the name of God, the Father Almighty,
heaven, he created incarnate by the Holy Spirit, of the Son of his Father. He suffered in his spirit. The third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again for the glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will never end.
So once again, I want to welcome you all to Meadows Presbyterian Church. We're so grateful and glad that you all can join us this morning for our time of worship. I want to extend a special invite to those who are online as well. Hope they're doing well. And we're really looking forward to this time that we can worship this morning. So a couple quick announcements as we continue on this morning. First off, to all the moms out there, happy Mother's Day. We hope that you all, yeah, there you go, a round of applause. We're so glad. For all your support for the youth and just for everyone in our lives. So thank you so much for that. As you've noticed, today is Youth Sunday. We've been preparing and are very excited to share. And we'll have a time where we'll do a scripture enactment, and then also we'll have a time to listen to some testimonies from both Callie and Emily, our graduating seniors. So we're looking forward to that this morning. Another couple announcements is since today is Mother's Day, we will not be having youth group tonight. So hopefully this afternoon you can celebrate the moms and have a good time and just enjoy the afternoon. And then next week we'll be having our last youth group for the year, so it'll be a final celebration. And for any available, the next week, the 26th, which is Memorial Day, but any families that are interested, we'll be having a cookout here for the youth, and any kids and families are invited for that as well. Are there any other announcements or anything else that would be that we should highlight this morning? Yes.
The mission study team would like everyone who hasn't done the survey yet to do it by May 14th. We do have paper copies if you don't want to do it online.
So the mission study team is looking for your continual support. So there's paper copies, or there was an online link sent. This helps ensure that we can continue moving forward in the best way possible. So if you have questions, you can contact any of the mission study team, but please continue to fill out those forms. Any other announcements this morning? Yes, good luck, Carlton. Memorial Day is Carlton's birthday, so a little happy early birthday to Carlton for Memorial Day. That's awesome. Happy early birthday. Well, let's transition our hearts into a time of prayer. Are there any joys or any concerns that we can bring forward this morning? Yes, Kristen. We rejoice with both of you. Any other prayer requests or joys? Yes, what's in?
I have a couple. One, my mother-in-law had cataract surgery last week, and she came through. That was a blessing without any problems. I have a friend from North Carolina who's dealing with breast cancer. If you can hold her up in prayer, her name is Laura. That would be wonderful.
Okay, so yeah, Cindy is saying that she has a friend in North Carolina dealing with breast cancer. Her name's Laura, correct? Yep, so praise for her and her healing. And also your mother-in-law was recovering from cataract surgery, yeah. So just praise that she continues to heal. Yes, Janine.
Prayers for Pat tonight, so she recovers from her surgery, and for Jim as he worries about her.
Okay, so prayers for Pat and Jim. Pat's recovering from surgery, so we lift her up in prayer as well. Yes. Yes, Lindsay.
Yay!
Oh, happy birthday, Daniel. Awesome. Yes, go ahead.
Just wanted to congratulate Bill on his retirement from GE/Emerson after almost 40 years. So.
Congratulations to Bill for his retirement from GE, 40 years. Now you can relax a little bit, so that's good. Yes, yes. Gabriella.
I'm new at this, you know. So I thought the big lunch was like after this. So I made a whole bunch of egg rolls for everybody. It'll be here. My son-in-law, who's a chef, is bringing it hot.
Maria is just going to quick announce that she made some egg rolls, correct? So afterwards, if anyone's hungry, I know we had breakfast earlier, but if anyone's still hungry, which I probably will be, so you can have some egg rolls afterwards.
We'll set them up out on the breezeway.
Yeah, we'll be in the breezeway, yes.
This past week, Austin and Maria celebrated their first anniversary.
Wonderful anniversary for Maria, so we're grateful for your support and God's blessing. Yes, Wyatt. Yes, Julie.
Hi, prayer for our granddaughter,
Emma, prayers for Julie's granddaughter, Emma, as she's recovering from having a spine injury and spine surgery. So prayers for her. Yes. Prayers for the students and the teachers out there in elementary schools too. So prayers for both of you as you finish up the school year, just a couple more weeks, whether that's exams or grading, we just pray that it's a good time as well.
I just wanted to offer some gratitude and thanksgiving for my wife who received her doctorate degree this past week. Yay! It's really hard for her. So beautifully over the last 3 years, in addition to being a mom and principal. So, congrats to Summer. We can call her doctor now.
Dr. Summer. Congratulations to her. Very accomplished. Wow. Well, let us join our hearts together in a time of prayer. We'll do a little different type of prayer this morning. So, it'll be kind of more of an interactive prayer. So this is called the hand prayer. Maybe some of you are familiar with it, maybe not, but that's all right. So everyone can kind of participate. So kind of hold your hands kind of in front of you, kind of with your thumb facing you, and just kind of start off in that position. So the thumb, we pray for those who are closest to us. So those who are maybe parents, mothers, brothers, sisters, grandparents, close friends, that's gonna represent the thumb. So the index finger, we call this the pointing finger. It reminds us of people who have pointed the way, the people who have guided us in our life. So maybe that's a teacher, maybe a pastor, maybe someone who's been a mentor in your life. We think of those people who have guided us. Then we have the middle finger, which is the biggest finger of all. And it reminds us to pray for those who have the most responsibilities. So maybe those in government, those who are local leaders, those like the president, those who are leaders in the community, we pray for those. And then the fourth finger, which is the weakest finger of all, we pray for those who are alone, maybe those who are dealing with mental illness, those who are in hospitals, rest homes, maybe poor or have not as much food to eat. And then the pinky is the little finger, and that comes last. And the Bible tells us we ought to put others before ourselves, we ought to pray for others first, and then for ourselves last. So I'll do kind of more of a general prayer, kind of reflecting on that model. So if you will, let us join together in this time of prayer. So let us pray. Lord God, thank you for making us part of your family and for giving us each our own families. Help us to love each other as you love us. Keep us safe and healthy, and to help us enjoy being with one another. Thank you for giving all kinds of people to teach us, our parents, grandparents, babysitters, friends, Sunday school leaders, teachers, and many more. Make them excited about what they teach and make us excited about learning more about you. Lord God, we can't even think of all the people who help us each day. Be our presidents, prime ministers, government leaders, help them to make good decisions. Please keep the police, firefighters, and all those in the city safe. And thank you for the other strong people who help take care of us. We also pray for those who are in need, anyone who's sick or scared, dealing with mental illness. We know that you are better than any doctor in my life. Give your strength to anyone who is suffering this morning. And we also ask you to bless each one of us. You are the greatest shepherd who loves us. Help us to know your will and always give us everything we need. Help us to be happy with what we have and continue to watch over us and teach us to live for you all of the time. And help us to continue to pray how you taught us to pray, saying, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
At this moment, I would like to invite Lindsay and Carter and Chris and any of the other kids to come on forward. We'll be continuing on with our children's moment this morning. We're really excited to see what y'all have prepared for us this morning. So any kids, feel free to come on up, and we're excited to share this time together this morning.
So we thought we'd start off with spotlighting future youth, which is our elementary school class. So those of you that have been in Sunday school, come and stand on this side of me, the left side. For those of you that haven't, you can just listen, and maybe you can join us next year for Sunday school. Okay, this year we learned the attributes of God, A through Z. And the kids each picked one letter that they'd like to share, or one word. So God is the
destroyer of evil.
He is also
glorious.
And also and finally
excellent.
And so each of these words had the Bible story that went with it to just help us see how big and wide and powerful our God is. The main thing that we focused on was the Romans Road to Salvation. I don't know if you are familiar with that, but we know that we're all sinners, and sin broke our way to God, and we needed a way to get back to Him. Without that way, we cannot have eternal life in heaven. So that's the big thing that we were focusing on. So in Romans, it tells us about how because of our sin, we're separated from God. And that's Romans 3:23, which says, the penalty for sin is death, and that's found in Romans 6:23. And that penalty, which is death, was paid for by the death of Jesus. God demonstrated his love for us by sending his son to take all of our sin, all of our punishment on himself, made a bridge, a way to get back to God. So that's found in Romans 5:8. And finally, if we repent of our sin and confess and trust Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, we'll be saved from that sin, but we have to call on his name. We find that in Romans 10:13. And Romans 10:9 tells us, so that's just a preview of our future youth.
As you have all done such a great job when I was in scripture, it helps us mind that the importance of having God's word on our hands. We are reminded of this through the Bible verse, Psalm 119:105. guides us every day and in all situations. We also read in Romans, which you all have been learning, and the importance of the Bible. So faith comes from hearing, and hearing through the word of God. Romans 10:17. You all have done such a great job to memorize God's word and keeping it close to your hearts. Thank you for sharing this time with us and using the word of God.
Dear God, we give you thanks for the chance to memorize and remember your word. Help us to keep it close to our hearts. We praise you for the ways in which you are working with the kids and the ways in which you will continue to work with this morning. Work with this morning. We love you, God. Amen.
Amen. So, we got 8 people. Ben and Terry.
On in the service, now will be the time for our offering. We'll be doing it a little bit different. We have the jar for the 5 cents meal and the church up there for the general fund. And we'll just have a time and continue with our service with our worship as the Spirit leads. So let us join as well in this song, We Will Feast in the House of Zion.
Our hearts restored, He's done great things. give us everything that is good, our homes, our food, our families, and our lives. All that we own and all that we are belong to you. Since you give us so much, we thank you by sharing our time, talents, right now, our money, and others. On this morning, the youth throughout this whole semester, kind of January to now in May, we've been looking through the book of John. So we've been studying kind of more the first part of John, around the first 12 chapters. But in kind of accordance with what we've been studying, we wanted to have a way to kind of reflect on what we've been studying. So we'll be doing a scripture enactment. So I will be reading from John 9, 1 through 34, which will come on and she'll read that up for us. And then after Abigail is done reading that, then we'll follow that time with a time of reflecting on the scripture with a reenactment. So feel free to come up.
As he passed by, he saw a man blind from birth, and his disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" Jesus answered, "It was not the man that sinned, or his parents, but that the works of God might be displayed in him. We must work the works of him who sent me while it is day. Night is coming when no one can work. As long as I am in this world, I am the light of the world." Having said these things, he spit on the ground and made mud with the saliva. Then he anointed the man's eyes with the mud and said to him, "Go wash in the pool of Siloam," which means sent. So he went and washed and came back seeing. The neighbors and those who had seen him before as a beggar were saying, "Is this not the man who used to sit and beg?" Some said, "It is he." Others said, "No, but he is like him." He kept saying, "I am the man." So they said to him, "Then how were your eyes opened?" He answered, "The man called Jesus made mud and anointed my eyes and said to me, 'Go to Siloam and wash.' So I went and washed and received my sight." They said to him, "Where is he?" He said, "I do not know." They brought him to the Pharisee, the man who had formerly been blind. Now it was a Sabbath day, when Jesus made the mud over his eyes. So the Pharisees again asked him how he had received his sight. And he said to them, "He put mud on my eyes, and I washed, and I see." Some of the Pharisees said, "This man is not from God, for he does not keep the Sabbath." But others said, "How can a man who is a sinner do such signs?" And there was a division amongst them. So they said again to the Bohemian, "What do you say about him, since he is the witness?" He said, "He is a prophet." The Jews did not believe that he had been blind and had received his sight until they called the parents of the man who had received his sight and asked them, "Is this your son, who you say was born blind? How then does he see?" His parents answered, "We know that this is our son and that he was born blind, but he now sees, we do not know. Nor do we know who opened his eyes. Ask him, he is of age, he will speak for himself." His parents said, His parents said these things because they feared the Jews, for the Jews had already agreed that if anyone should confess Jesus to be Christ, he was to be put in the synagogue. End parenthesis. Therefore, his parents said, "He is of age. Ask him." So for the second time, they called the man who had been blind and said to him, "Give glory to God. We know that this man is a sinner." He answered, Whether he is a sinner, I do not know. One thing I do know, and though I was blind, now I see. They said to him, what did he do to you? How did he open your eyes? He answered them, I have told you already, and you would not listen. Why do you want to hear it again? Do you want to become his disciples? And they reviled him, saying, you are his disciple, but we are disciples of Moses. We know that God has spoken to Moses, but as for this man, we do not know where he comes from. The man answered, why, this is an amazing thing. You do not know where he comes from, and yet he opened my eyes. We know that God does not listen to sinners, but if anyone is a worshiper of God and does his will, God listens to him. Never since the world, sorry, the Bible's confused. Never since the world began has it been heard that anyone opened the eyes of a man born blind. If this man were not from God, he could do nothing. They answered him, you were born in utter sin, and would you teach us? And they cast him out. Jesus heard that they had cast him out, and having found him, he said, do you believe in the Son of Man? He answered, and who is he, sir, that I may believe in him? Jesus said to him, you have seen him, and it is he who is speaking to you. He said, Lord, I believe, and we worshiped him. Jesus said, for judgment I came into this world, that those who do not see may see, and those who see may not become blind. Some of the Pharisees near him heard these things and said to him, are we also blind? Jesus said to them, and if you were blind, you would have no guilt. But now that you say you see, your guilt remains.
This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So we'll begin. So those in the first scene, feel free to come on up. So what we're going to do is we'll have a couple of different scenes, and each scene will represent some different characters. So we'll have a narrator. Yep, that's great. We got the narrator and a couple of people acting out within the scene. So we'll just kind of go for it and just have some fun. So
this man is sinner, nor his parents, but they said that the works of God might be discussed. Right now, it is day. The night is coming. And no one can work in the night. Night is coming when no one can work. While I am in the world, I am the world. Wash in the pool of the Lord.
Which is translated sent. So you run away and wash and you can not see.
Therefore the neighbors and those who previously saw him as a beggar would say,
is this not the one who used to sit and beg?
Others were saying,
this is he.
Still others were saying,
no, but he is like him.
He kept saying,
I am the one.
So they were saying to him,
and how then were your eyes open?
He answered,
the man who was called Jesus made clay and anointed my eyes. He said to me, go to Siloam and wash. So I went away and washed.
They said to him,
we
Where is he?
He said,
I do not know.
Now it was a Sabbath on the day when Jesus came to play and opened his eyes. Then the Pharisees also were asking him again how he received his sight. He said to them,
He applied clay to my eyes, and I watched and I see.
Therefore, some of the Pharisees were saying,
this man is not from God, because he does not keep the Sabbath.
But others were saying, how can a man who is a sinner perform such signs? And there was a debate among them. So they said to the blind man again, what do you say about him, since he opened your eyes? And he said,
he's a prophet.
Is this your son, and you say he was born blind? And how does he now see?
His parents answered them and said,
we know he is our son, and that he was born blind.
But how he now sees, we do not know. Or who opened his eyes, we do not know. Ask him, he is of age, he will speak for himself.
His parents said this because they were afraid of the Jews. For the Jews had already agreed that if anyone confessed him to be Christ, he was to be put out of the synagogue. For this reason, his parents said, he is of age, ask him.
So a second time they called the man who had been blind and said to him,
give glory to God, for we know this man is a sinner.
He then answered,
whether he's a sinner, I do not know. One thing I do know, that though I was blind, now I see.
So they said to him,
what did he do? How did he open your eyes?
He answered them,
I told you already, you did not listen. Why do you want to hear it again? You do not want to become his disciples too, do you?
They reviled him and said to them,
you are his disciple, but we are disciples of Moses. We know that God has spoken to Moses, but as for this man, we do not know where he is from.
The man answered and said to them,
well, here's the amazing thing. As you do not know where he is from, and yet he opened my eyes. We know that God does not hear sinners, but if anyone is God-fearing and does his will, he hears him. Since the beginning of time, it has never been heard that anyone opened the eyes of a person born blind. If this man were not from God, he could do nothing.
They answered him,
you were born entirely in sins. Are you teaching us?
So they put him out.
Jesus thought that they had put him out, and finding him, he said,
do you believe in the Son of Man?
He answered,
who is he, Lord, that I may believe in him?
Jesus said to him,
you have both seen him, and he is the one who is talking to you.
And he said,
Lord, I believe.
And he worshipped him. And Jesus said,
for judgment I came into this world, so that those who did not see me may see, and those who see me may become blind.
Those of the Pharisees who were with him heard these things and said to him,
we are not blind too, are we?
Jesus said to them,
if you were blind, you would have no sin. But since you say, we see, your sin remains. Well done. Good job, everyone. Good job.
As we have listened to and witnessed God's word, we give thanks for his healing power. Jesus healed the blind man, and we give thanks for his testimony as the blind man was able to witness and tell others what Jesus had done for them. So as we've seen and heard, testimonies have great power. We are able to witness the ways in which God has blessed us and that God has been active in our lives. So this morning, we also have the honor to listen to two testimonies from both Kylie and Emily as they share their testimonies with us. And just as the blind man was given glory to Jesus and testified to others what Jesus had done in his life, we're able to listen to Kylie and Emily and have them share what Jesus has done in their life. So I'd like to first up invite Kylie to share her testimony. So Kylie, come on up, and we're excited for listening to what God has prepared for your heart.
Hello, if you don't know me, my name is Callie Wood, and my family and I have been coming to Meadows since 2016. I will be graduating from Alma High School in a few short weeks, and will be attending the University of Virginia next year. Before coming to Meadows, my family didn't consistently attend church every Sunday. My parents both came here when they were growing up, but after college, neither one of them came back often. Before we started coming to Meadows as a family, my parents took us to a couple different churches in Charlottesville to try and find a church where we could start regularly attending, and nothing really felt like the right fit. So they decided to try Meadows again, and after coming for a while, it just felt like home. When I was little and throughout most of elementary school, I struggled with the concept of God actually existing and not just being a figure up in the sky. I didn't understand why we should read and follow a book called the Bible. Going to church felt like something expected, and that I was just going through the motions each week. When I soon learned that God actually is a real person and existed in history, things began to click and make more sense. Some nights before I was going to bed, I would pick up the Bible in my nursery drawer and read parts of Genesis. I was so curious about how God created everything and what that looked like. One of my favorite memories at Meadows has been helping out with VBS. I've always loved interacting with younger kids and watching them form personalities. Experiences like this and babysitting has allowed me to see how God makes each person unique and special. In the summer of 2019, I got to go on a church camp called The Great Escape. I was hesitant about if I wanted to go because I was the only youth signed up, but looking back, it was one of the best weeks of my life. I convinced my best friend and another current youth, Annabelle Lindsay, to come with Christian Theobald youth throughout the time. We stayed at a college campus in Pennsylvania and got to worship God without many distractions. Being surrounded by so many believers our age is extremely powerful and something that I won't forget the feeling of. For one of the first times, I lifted my arms and said in prayer because I could feel the presence of God in the auditorium we were in. I learned the meaning of what it means to embrace your faith to the fullest. I could see the Lord working in other people through the joy and excitement they had to worship Him. Prayer for me has been the constant thing that has connected me to God the most. Any time of the day or in any situation, I can talk to Him and know that He is listening. It just brings a sense of peace to me that only God can provide. I am able to use prayer for many different things, and I know that there is no wrong thing you can say to God. One of my favorite Bible verses is Mark 11:24, which says, therefore, I tell you, whatever you ask in prayer, believe that you have received it and that it will be yours. Even in times when I haven't felt super close to God, He always finds a way to remind me that He is still there. Last year, my family lost their 3-year-old pug unexpectedly due to sudden health complications. I was heartbroken and struggled to understand why God would let something like this happen to us and why He would let me be in so much pain. It was hard for me to feel loved by Him at that time, but I knew that everything was going to be okay. Because God had a plan for me, and that He was going to be there with me every step of the way. I am a big believer in that everything happens for a reason, so I just had to trust that something good was going to come from this. We later got another pug that brought so much joy to our family, and I felt like there were signs from God that this new dog was supposed to be with us. Throughout high school, I felt like my faith has been constantly growing through each chapter of my life. Come to school, you include Bible studies and worship services have enabled me to interpret the meaning of God and understand more about what He wants us, how He wants us to live our life. From starting high school during the COVID-19 pandemic to applying to colleges this year, I'm reminded that the Lord has a path laid out for me and that everything is going to be okay. I know that He loves me unconditionally and will never leave my side. One day when I leave this earth, I know that heaven will be so much greater than any of us can even imagine, and that it will be right there with God.
Around Thanksgiving, there were Thanksgiving messages, and this was based on lessons.
blessing suggestion when I keep a gratitude journal. This gratitude finally allowed me to see all the light in the darkness and carry on forward. Building myself a shield of gratitude allowed me to grow stronger in love, hope, and peace internally, so that I wouldn't be as affected by events externally. These are all things that Christ has given me, and I am so thankful to Christ and to all of you for pushing me to hold the light in the dark times and hold on to all of it. When I look back at earlier this year, I can see how I felt a lack of love from different people, and how I tried to fill and ignore that emptiness in different ways. I would make more friends, I texted my friends a lot, I distracted myself. I didn't allow myself to be alone, because when I was alone, I felt that emptiness heavily. And while all that helped, there was still something I could feel missing. 1 John 4:19 says, "We love because He first loved us." Over time, I felt God's love and presence in my life through different events. Meeting up for dinners with Leslie and Kirsten, becoming closer to some of my friends in youth group, reading the Bible more often, and truly looking to Him for guidance and not just an easy fix. As His love entered my life was filled with more light. Illuminated, He led me out of the darkness. Because God loved me, because I could feel His love through other people, I was able to apply the same love to myself, loving myself and my light. But allowing the light and love He put into my life to illuminate others. As for feeling weak, looking back, I can see all the strength that allowed me to push through times of weakness. This may seem counterintuitive, but you have to be strong to be weak, to have all your fences fall and your castles crumble, to move through that time, not to only survive from the experience, but to grow from it. That is not weakness. That is strength. But it is not my strength alone. I didn't see it back then, but God was helping lead me through the darkness. Nothing this year went to plan, literally nothing. And yes, I got hurt and I cried and I felt alone. And even though I would never want to relive it for all of it, I wouldn't wish to change it. It was in these hard experiences that I was able to grow. It was through the darkness and emptiness that I was finally able to see His marvelous light. And I know somehow this series of events were to take place tomorrow, I would be stronger because I have learned from these experiences and I have God on my side. And the Bible says, "If He is for me, who can be against me? For not a hair can fall from my head without His notice. I can cast all my anxiety onto the Lord, and He will reply with peace and love always."
Listen to these testimonies. Let us now join together in a song of response, the goodness of God.
As a father. Given to us by our gracious
God. May the grace of God, deeper than our imagination,
the strength of Christ, stronger than our need,
and the communion of the Holy Spirit, richer than our togetherness,
guide and sustain us today and in all of our tomorrows.
Amen.
Amen.
Sing Days of Elijah. And if you know the motions, you better do it.
It's me.
There's no God like Jehovah.
God like Jehovah. There's no 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 God like Jehovah. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, and the trumpet call, lift your voice, it's a year of jubilee. Oh, lift your voice, it's a year of jubilee.